and got an amazingly wonderful, full of holiday cheer show. So please help me in welcoming our first performer, Mr. Barry Bates.
Santa baby, I met on this very stage about 15 years ago. We've gone through quite a bit together. I fell asleep one night because Evo in his backyard after a cast party. He just left me there. I woke up the next morning. They're like, you okay? I'm like, yeah, okay, sure. Okay, went on, you know, good times. So, I thought for tonight, Christmas, I would write a little poem just for him. And I would like to read that. Sorry, cold fingers. Ode to Martin by Tracy Sutherland. Martin Carney is the best. He's better than all the rest. Well, most. Have. Okay, at least 25%, at least 25% of the rest, he's the best. His generosity and kindness are notorious. His stories and tales are mostly uproarious. And yes, that's a word. I looked it up. Google thesaurus. Great. He can put on a show with the easiest of ease, and he hardly ever smells like blue cheese. Especially since he got that toe fungus cleaned up about a month ago. Woo! Or then, no, 20 feet radius, sir, you stay back there. He loves growing plants. Could probably even grow vanilla. But his meatloaf could choke a 1,000-pound gorilla. Are you ready? Oh, there you are. Oh, my gosh, last day, you finally get here?
I'm going to go ahead and sing now, if that's okay. Are you through? You're through, right?
I think so.
Okay.
For now.
For now.
For now.
Okay.
Martin Carney, ladies and gentlemen. You were behind me the whole time? I give him this really great intro, this fun little ditty, and he's not even ready.
Well, you're supposed to bring my guitar out.
I was not. Good job. Martin Carney!
Not everybody gets introduced like that. And by the way, my meatloaf is great.
That's what we pay them to tell you.
But anyway, thank you very much for being here tonight or this afternoon. I've been a volunteer down here at the Art Center for quite a few years, and it never ceases to amaze me the quality of the performers that come across the stage. I mean, we've had some great ones. There's some good ones sitting out in the audience today that have graced our stage. And the ones that are here now, the new generation, are just as talented as ever.
Woo!
And so Lindsay came in and she said, Martin, well, I want you to do a song. And I said, wow, okay. And I went home and told my wife, Connie, and I said, Lindsay wants me to sing a song. I said, I'm home. And she said, well, okay, what are you going to do? I said, I think I'll do my Christmas song. And she said, okay. I came back, I was feeling pretty good about myself until she told me that it was for comic relief that I was. So it kind of knocked me down a peg. So anyway, I wrote this song, and it actually started out as I just wrote the words down. And Connie told me, she said, you know you got to put music in that. I said, okay. So I wrote some music for her. And she said, well, that's not very good. You're going to have to do better than that. And I said, well, okay. So this has been kind of a work in progress for a few years. Not every iteration I go up and say, how about this? She said, we just about got it. But anyway, I hope you enjoy it. Watching the snow, and up in the sky up above my house, I saw something that caused my mind to blow. It was a sleigh of sorts pulled by some deer, but I really wasn't sure till they got near. And there were jingling bells and a ho, 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 and I thought, what in the world's going on here? Now, they were coming fast, and I didn't think they'd stop. And then, to my surprise, they did a circle move and came to a landing right on my rooftop. Now, the driver was a man dressed all in red, from his pantaloons to the top of his head, and I heard him exclaim as he came to a stop, "Boys, that was kind of close." So he dropped his reins and he hopped right down so he could lock his skids. Then he hollered to the deer, "I'll be right back. Let me leave these toys for the kids." Now the roof on my house is kind of steep, and I'm not like things to keep orderly or in their place, you know, the way they're supposed to be. So he took one step and tripped on a limb, and I'm here to tell you, Jim, that that big old man came tumbling down and hit the ground right in front of me. "Well, it's been a long time since I've done that," he said with a grin as he grabbed his hat. "Since you're here, you can help me out. I tell you, let's go in through the door." Well, he moved through the house with grace and ease, put those toys out pretty as you please, and when he was through, he took a look around and he said, "This ain't bad." So he looked in the corner, saw the cookies and milk, and he said, "Man, I know those must be for me. But I tell you, in the spirit of Christmas cheer, I'd just soon have a beer." So we drank us a beer and talked for a minute or two, and then he said, "Martin, I got things to do." So he grabbed his sack and he walked outside and he looked up in the sky. Now I've had this old job of mine for a really, really long old time. But until tonight, I've never stopped and just talked with a friend of mine. Yeah, this old job keeps me hopping, and I gotta move pretty fast. But there's just some things in this old world that you just can't let get past. So I got my ladder up against the house so he could reach his sleigh. And when he got to the top, he hollered back down, "I got one thing left to say. I will return," he said with glee, "of that have no fear. But before I get back to your house next Christmas, please make sure the roof is clear." And he hollered to the reindeer, "Boys, we must be on our way. We got toys to deliver until the break of day." And as he lifted from the roof and he slid out of my sight, I heard him say, "Merry Christmas and to all a good night. Merry Christmas to all and to all a good night." Now, ladies and gentlemen, the lovely Miss Celeste Alexander. He's got a sleigh, it's not on his paper. He's got a jump on his paper.
done everything you should. Extra special good, he'll make this December the one you'll remember. Best and the merriest you ever did have. Everybody's waiting. They're all congregating, waiting for the man with a bag. Ooh, waiting for the man with a bag. Merry Christmas.
Amazing vocalist that I've ever met here in this community, and she's now my friend, Mrs. Ashley Thompson, with singing Blue Christmas.
Oh, sweet time. having a good time enjoying yourselves thoroughly so far. But wait, there's more. Next singing, I'll be home for, oh my Lord, what is this? Singing, I'll be home for Christmas, Tracy Sutherland.
Yeah.
motley crew of singers and dancers with their take on a holiday classic. I hope you enjoy.
Oh, Cream collar, concord, harmonies and sisters, crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells.
Changing, I'm rearranging.
old rock for you guys. So give him a hand.
Thank you. Thank you. and the Dazettes.
They will be performing What Christmas Means to Me.
And as we tread the dream, how much fun.
Green Donald with the Christmas song.
Christmas is here, bring me the cheer, to Dunning on feet. cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how the bell will ring.
Thank you.
of Razzle Dazzle, a holiday spectacle.